Pastor, Pastor Bob, this morning, honor our pastor. Okay, you guys remain standing. While they're getting set up, I'm going to lay a hand on Pastor Bob, extend a hand towards him, and let's pray. Father God, we thank you for our head pastor. I thank you for our vision carrier. God, thank you for what you have placed inside this man to give to your people, to give to the world. God, bless him today. I pray that your word would come straight through his mouth, God, and it would be sharper than any two-edged sword. Lord, we bless you for that. We honor you this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning. Good morning, church.
Morning.
Okay, so I have some here good stuff, okay? So I'm giving away a lot of stuff. A book by Liv Hetland, Supernatural Abundance, okay? And then another one, A Time to Prosper by Chuck Pierce. And then we have Transformed by Love. So I'm giving all these books. I'm giving a box of Shipley Donuts. Yeah, a dozen of this, okay? And also, one more. My daughter baked a cheesecake. Yeah, that's really freshly... it tastes good. So I'm giving all those things. And watch the catch, Pastor Bob. Okay, the catch is this. I need two volunteers, a girl and a boy, or, male and female, okay? So what's going to happen, I have a dozen of egg here. So on the dozen of egg, you have, there's six boiled egg here and six raw eggs. So what you're going to do, you're going to be sitting here, and you're going to choose one egg, okay? And then the one you choose, every time, you're going to crack it to your face. In your face or in your hair. But I provide you already a wipes. So later, if you're up with that, you're going to get all this stuff, okay? So there's six of that. So who among you want to do this? Okay, Adrian, come over here. Okay, all right. I'll get you, sister. Okay. All right. This is going to be cool. All right. You help me out. Okay. The one who's going to have a lot of raw eggs wins, okay? So, yeah, if you have like, because there's six of them, six eggs, raw eggs, then they need to crack it in their face or in their hair or whatever they want to do. Are you ready for this? Is it okay to have fun in church? Yes, it's Easter. All right, so let's start with Adrian. Okay, so choose one egg. When you choose one, that's it, okay? All right. Okay, so are you guys ready? You're going to count 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, go! Okay, it's a boiled egg. It's a boiled egg. Okay, good. Now, so, okay, let's throw this. Help me out. Thank you. Next. Okay, choose one. Okay, who are you gonna count? One. Okay, 1, 2, 3, go! Oh, it's a boiled egg, Okay, next. Adrian, it's your turn again. Okay, count. Okay, all right. All right, it's a volunteer. Okay, all right, that's okay. So, 1 point for Adrian, okay? 1 for you. All right, Jennifer, are you ready for this? Okay, guys, count. 1, 2, 3, go! So, 1 and 1. Okay. Oh, by the way, we will do the wiping later. Okay, so we will do the wiping later, okay? Okay, it's okay. Your parents will not be mad, huh? Oh, you changed some clothes. All right, okay. All right, next. Okay. 1, 2, 3, go! Okay, again. 1, 2, 3, go! What is that? What's that? Okay, but all right, so 2, 1, okay? One, two, three, go. Oh, is it? Again. Did it go? No, again. No, go. It's a bold egg, okay. Yeah, I really bowled it for 2 hours. Okay. Okay. I don't know how to bowl egg. Okay, we're ready. Okay. One, two, three. Get it, bro. Go. Oh, yeah. It's a bold egg? Okay, bold egg. Okay. Oh, how many more left? So 2-1, isn't it? Okay. Okay, faster. One, two, three, go. Oh, it's a bold egg. Okay. Okay, ball, three, okay. All right, Jennifer, you ready? With impact, resurrection day. One, two, three, go! Ah! Okay. Okay. So how many? She has 3-1. Okay. Okay. One, two, three, go! Ah! I love you, bro. I love you, bro. Okay. So how many now? 2-1. 3-0? Oh, 2-3. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, one. Out. Oh, that's it. Okay. So who won? Jennifer won. Thank you. So this is going to be the gift. Okay. What do you want? Do you want the cheesecake or the chipotle donut? Thank you. Then you have the donut. Okay, share. And then you have this book, Transformed by Love, by Lev Hetland. You have A Time to Prosper. And then you have also Supernatural Abundance. It's going to happen. And for you, it's going to have a chocolate. God bless you. Thank you. So, did you have fun? Okay, all right, Pastor. Okay, hallelujah. Now, let's work on the Word of God now. Amen. Okay. All right. Okay, now what's next? Okay. I forgot this one. Okay, sorry. Yes. Okay. So, you know, eggs symbolize life. You know, that's why we have eggs, because it's a start of new life. And I believe I'm going to speak a word today. But before that, we need to know the story of the resurrection. We need to read the story, and we need to, so we're going to talk about the resurrection. Let's go on to the story. Danny, would you please place the story of the resurrection? So help me out. I want you, everybody, to stand up, please. Come on. Let's honor the Word of God. Everybody honor the Word of God, and we're going to speak about the resurrection. So Jesus died for 3 days, and it's Sunday, okay? So let's go. One, two, three, go. And Sabbath ended. Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome went out and burned spices so they could anoint Jesus' body. the good news to everyone. Anyone who believes and is baptized will be saved, but anyone who refuses to believe will be condemned. This miraculous sign will accompany those who believe. They will cast out demons in my name, and they will speak in new languages. They will be able to handle snakes with safety. If they drink anything poisonous, it won't hurt them. They will be able to place their hands on the sick, and they will be healed. When the Lord Jesus had finished talking with them, he was taken up into heaven and sat down in the place of honor of God's right hand. And the disciples went everywhere and preached, and the Lord worked through them and confirming what they said with many miracle signs. You can be seated. So that's the story of the resurrection. So what happened is that there, Jesus died on Friday, and then for Saturday, and then Saturday, the women bought some spices, because that's how they honored the body. They put some spices on that. So they bought on Saturday, and on Sunday, they went to the tomb. And they said, they're talking to themselves, how can we roll out the stone? Because it takes, according to the Jewish scholars, it takes 20 people, men, to pull out the stone. 20. Okay, so it's really heavy stone. So they're thinking about who's going to pull out the stone, because we're women. Okay, so as soon as they went there, they saw that the tomb is what? Rolled away, and it's open. And then they went inside, and they found an angel. And the angel said, your Jesus was crucified, was on the cross, he was risen from the dead. So what happened, they were so astonished, and they went out, and they said, and the angel said, go and tell the disciple. It's so funny, because they want the ladies to know first. I don't know why not men, because I think men don't talk too much. The ladies, I don't know why. See, God can use who you are, especially if you're a woman. That's why God loves women in the body of Christ. You have a place in the body of Christ that man cannot do. So what happened then, the angel told them, go and tell the people, the disciple, that you know what? That Jesus rose from the dead. And what happened is that, but they were so confused. These women are confused because they don't expect it. Okay? So imagine that if you're any woman here. Anybody here, woman here? Okay. For sure, okay? Now, if you're a woman, the angel told you, come on, get out and tell the people, tell your family that Jesus is alive. Amen. Man, it's an opportunity. It's like an honor to do that. So what happened is that, so they went there, and then the story, what else happened? There is Mary Magdalene. Oh, see, Mary Magdalene was delivered with 7 demons. And the Lord showed first to Mary Magdalene. Woman, again. Do you know that in the history they found out that through Mary Magdalene, it was the gospel was preached to the different part of the nation because of a woman. So do not say that woman doesn't have any place in the body of Christ. God can use you. And come on, you're not happy about that. God can use you. If God can use man, he can use woman. If God can use a donkey, if God can use a rooster, he can surely use woman and man. Amen? So what happened is that, she was blessed. Because what? She saw the resurrected Jesus. She's the first one who saw the resurrected Christ. So what happened, and then the Lord showed to Mary Magdalene, and then after that, they begin to, Jesus told, tell the people that I'm alive. And then what happened is that the 11 disciples, they're still they're eating. They love to eat. So they're eating, and then Jesus showed up. And Jesus showed up and said, and then finally they believe. Jesus needs to deal their unbelief. poor, they can see the miraculous. So that's what happened, and then what happened, and then he told them what to do. He told them to do miracles, and then after that, Jesus went up to heaven. So that's the story. Let's go out and eat now. Amen. Well, anyway, let's just have a, let's talk about the Word of God, okay? So, we talk about the story. We're done with the story. Long story. It's a 20 verses story. Death is necessary to experience resurrection. Death is necessary. You need to die before you be resurrected. Some of us here, you are facing a lot of stuff in your life. And in the worship, we're talking about there's a lot of dead things in our life. Some of you may be here said, I have a dead relationship. I have a debt, my finances is dying. Or my purpose in God is dying. Or everything that I see is death. Anybody can identify with me like that? Something like really, it's there's no life in it. You need to die so God can resurrect you. You are in the best position right now. You are in the best position right now to be resurrected by God. So have hope, this mega hope that regardless of my situation right now, regardless of my finances, regardless of my addiction, regardless of all my stuff happening with me, this is my best position for me to be resurrected by God. So don't lose hope, friends. Don't lose hope. Don't be discouraged. Because God is about to raise you up. He's about to get you. He's about to resurrect your situation. Anybody's excited about that? Some dead things in our life is because of our stupidity. Because of our choice. Come on, let's just, because we choose like this, and that's why death comes. But some of the things that are dead things, we're experiencing death, sometimes we don't have any choosing. It just came, God allowed it. Or some people's choice, and we experience it. Regardless of your situation, God can still resurrect your situation. Regardless of that motive of that situation, regardless of those things, God can resurrect you. Hallelujah. So let's go further. Resurrection is a supernatural. Thank you, Rhoda. You're the only one believing that. Resurrection is supernatural. I'm going to speak to you. Resurrection is supernatural. See, I want to tell you something. We live so much in a natural life. We've been living so much in natural that sometimes to believe the supernatural is really hard. Do you think that God can heal cancer? Do you think that God can heal marriages? Can God deliver some addiction, some pornography, and all these vices in your life? Can God deliver you? Let's believe. Resurrection is a supernatural. See, this is it. I want to tell you. You know that you are made of a body and a soul and a spirit. You have a soul who lives in a body, and also you have a spirit. That spirit is alive when you got born again. What's born again? When you said, God, come to my heart, be my Savior, my Lord, automatically your spirit come to alive. Now, let me ask you. If you really know, and you know, and you know, and you know, and you really know that you have the Spirit of God, say, amen.
Amen.
Are you born again Christian?
Amen.
You need to believe that. Now, you have the Spirit of God. The problem is this, what we do in our life is that we walk by sight, we walk by what we feel, we walk by what we see, we don't walk by the Spirit of God. And sometimes we miss it. When God does supernatural, our mind is not ready. He's so much ready to do miracles. He's so much ready to do deliverance in your life, but your mind is not ready. That's why we need to teach you. We need to need to renew our mind. Renewing his mind is repentance. Repentance means that, sorry for my sin. That's not repentance. True repentance, the Bible says, is changing of your mindset. This is your thinking, and then it suddenly changes. Hallelujah. I'm excited about this. Now, do you know that When Jesus, in Genesis 1, this is what the Lord said. Let's make man to our own image and likeness. Do you know when he said that? He said that man is a supernatural being. Amen. That they have the spirit. That God infused his spirit. And then after that, in Genesis 3, what had happened is that he formed the man into the dust. And he breathed to that spirit. So everything is all about supernatural. It's all about the spirit of God. But we miss to walk in the supernatural. We are so sub-level to the supernatural. That's why in supernatural, we need to believe. The resurrection, how can I believe that? It's not proven. Do you know that resurrection is proven historically? It's proven historically. Like when you remove, if you deny resurrection, you're just saying that, for example, the World War II, it didn't happen. Or like the 9/11 didn't happen. But there's a proof. There's a proof historically by the historian. Record everything. There's like a 500 people witness the Lord Jesus walking on the planet Earth after the resurrection. There's 500 plus people resurrected when he was resurrected on this mark. So Jesus ascended to heaven. It's proven. And science also agree with it. Look at you. Check it. Google it. I love Google. Google it. Scientific, and it's there. And the scientists are believing now. Because really, he resurrected. If there's no resurrection, he's just like a Muhammad. He's just like Buddha. He's just Confucius or Gandhi, normal people. But he's not. My God is alive and resurrected from the dead. Yes, people resurrected like Lazarus. You may say, oh, Lazarus was resurrected. Yes, but Lazarus went back to death. But my Jesus, he is the only one who stayed alive in a mortal body and went to heaven. He is the only one. Enoch didn't die. He was resurrected. He was transformed, go to heaven, teleported in heaven, but he didn't die. But only Jesus alone who died and come back and living in a body. Now, God wants to invite you to taste again the supernatural. That you need to, like, when you go to work, that something good's gonna happen in your work. That something supernatural, that your paycheck is not only your paycheck, your source is God. God can bless you more than your paycheck. Yes, you have cancer that you trust on the chemotherapy, but God is greater than that chemotherapy. That you have a counselor who take care of your marriage issues or your addiction, but God is better. God is greater than the counselor you have. God is asking us, come on, have a little taste of my intervention. Have a little taste of my interaction to you. Become so natural. Oh, you're sick. Tylenol. No money. Save money or borrow. No answer prayer. You go back to your old nature. You get hurt. See, the problem is, sometimes your prayer, you might be praying and then something that didn't happen. Don't disvalue God just for one prayer that hasn't been answered. Devalue God, just one prayer that there's no answer. Or maybe dead in your family. Don't disvalue that, but he's still alive. Amen? Now, I am a spirit and a supernatural being. Say with me, I am a spirit. Now, are you a supernatural being? You ought to bring supernatural in your hands. We need to see miracles in our hands. Miracles should be normal. Come on, miracles should be normal. Your mind is disagreeing. Miracles should be normal to every believer. Come on, just taste it. That when you pray for the sick, they get recovering. But when you pray for them, they're getting dying. No, continue doing that until your faith grows. Amen? Okay, let's go. Now, resurrection empowers me to do the supernatural. Do you know the best, the legit, like the maximum supernatural happen is the resurrection? There's an angel, there's Jesus getting up. It's as powerful. And yet, we believers fall short on believing the resurrection. Perhaps nothing happening in your life because you don't really fully persuaded about the power of resurrection. See, let me tell you this. When Jesus, he preached the parables, he preached all this teaching, but when he resurrected from heaven, he told the disciples, you know, they begin to preach about the resurrection power. In Acts, the book Acts, they preach about the resurrection. That's why supernatural things happen, because they preach the resurrection. They didn't preach about the parables. They didn't preach about the Beatitudes, but they preach the power of the resurrection. From Jesus died on the cross, risen from the dead, and ascended to heaven. They began to preach about that. And 3,000 got saved. In another few days, 5,000 got saved. Miracles upon miracles happened because they preached about resurrection. Amen. Now, we need to really believe this. You want a miracle happen in your life, in your personal life? Believe the power of the resurrection. It becomes so natural because the gadget we have is so easy to explain. But really, when you believe, God is asking us to believe. Okay. In New Living Translation, my favorite verse is, I've been meditating this verse for a week now. I want to go further, another week for me. Oh, okay, I will give you an instant assignment. All of River of Life will meditate one verse. This verse, Romans 8:11. And do you want to know what it is about? The Spirit of God, who raised Jesus from the dead, lives in you. It's just like a past gas, you know? It doesn't know reality. But really, when you really think about it, what's meditation? You really, yummy. And then you swallow it like a cow, and then you gurgle it again. Like how this is. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead is inside of me. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead is inside of you. You don't get it. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead inside of you, bro. No sin can stand. No disease can stand. Because the Spirit of God, the same Spirit. It's not equal. It's not equal. Like, what's equal? For example, 1 + 1 = 2. Equals 2. All right, I know. 1 + 1 = 2. There's another formula with that. 0 + 2 = 2. So it's the same, equal. But that's not what the Bible equality is saying about the Spirit. It's the same. It's not equal. It's the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. It's inside of you when you got born again. Man, when you begin to think about that, when you begin to think about that, you memorize it. Yes, the Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead lives inside of me. So no sickness should not dwell in my body. No viruses, no bacteria, whatever it is, no discouragement, no all this sadness, depression. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead is inside of me. It's an atomic bomb. It's an atomic Hiroshima bomb. It's like a bigger bomb. Amen. There's no way that you'll be depressed. With all the sweat I have. I don't care. I want you to get it. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead lives, dwells, resides inside of you. But I'm sinful. I am sinful. Shut up. Your mind's beginning to tell the devil, yeah, but you know, Mama, I just think about this. Because you always think about that negative. That's why you get able to dwell on those good stuff. Replace, we talk about, put off and put on. Put off the old mindset, that stinking coconut. Remove that stuff. Those that you are a failure, that you are abused, forget that. Tell them, I am a child of God. Yeah, I was abused before. I don't care. The greater is in me than he in the world. The same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead is inside of me and lives inside of me. Tell me. Yes, I need a towel. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay. And then it didn't finish there. It said here, lives in you, and just as God raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give you life to your mortal bodies, to your body now, not only when you go to heaven, now. You need the benefit of God's intervention now, not when you go to heaven. You need the victory now. You need the healing now. You need prosperity now. You need healing now. He said here, and just as God, I said, not just God raised Christ, Jesus Christ from the dead, he will give you life. Just give you life. Let me tell you, what life are you getting? Oh my gosh. He will give you life to your mortal body by the same again. Okay, how many same here? That's only one. Okay, it's only one. I think I'm meditating too much. The same Spirit living within you. Forget everything what we've done. Memorize the scripture. Spit it out. When you're sleeping, remember about before you go to sleep until it becomes like a stronghold in your life. And you start believing that God is so big. Right now it's really hard to believe because our mind is full of negativity. But now when you meditate it, it's easy to see the supernatural. Hallelujah. Resurrection produces power. You have power inside of you? No, I don't believe that. Do you know you have the power inside of you? Come on. Do you really, really, really know that there's power inside of you? There is this Holy Spirit. There's the Holy Spirit not only around you, but inside of you. The Bible says, but my body is a temple of the Holy Ghost. But my body, your body, everybody's body. I got the power. I got the power. And that the power of the Holy Ghost, that Michael Jackson, I got the power. You got the power. Come on. This resurrection really challenged me, this verse, and it challenged me, this message, because I know resurrection, Easter, egg, all those things, bunny, all these things, but there's so much life, there's so much power. See what happened? The 11 disciples really immersed themselves in the resurrection message, and they changed the nation, the whole course of the universe to the power of resurrection. They preach it. And something happened. The same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is inside of you. Resurrection gives you life. It gives you life. He gives you life. Okay? Now, what kind of life is that? The Greek word for, in the Bible said here, in Romans 8:11, in a new, different translation, but the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you. He resides in you. He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by the spirit that dwelleth in you. It quickened. And the quicken means here, the word quicken is a zupoea. I don't know how to say that. Zupoea. I don't know what's that. I don't know. Zupoea. Okay. It means, it's a Greek, okay? It means, see, the Lord was really upgrading me from learning English to Greek now, huh? You are a supernatural God. Zupoeo. Anyway, it means this quicken, it means to restore to life. God in the business of restoring your life. He want to restore you. He don't want you to be on that pit. He wants to get you up and then restore. He's a God of restoration. What the enemy, your enemy has been eating your lunch for longest time, but it will restore what he has stolen from you. I'm not just trying to make you happy. It's really what happened. I'm not trying to endorse like this. The Lord is endorsing it. Just to believe. Okay, now, zupio means endued with new life. It's like you are destined. It's like you're full of it, full of new life. New, not old life, not repurposed life. Repurposed, like they fix it. No, that's not the good Lord. When you say new life, when you are born again Christian, you are a new life. No one created being have done like that. It's just repurposed. If you have a phone, you repurpose it. It's an old phone, but they just fix it. You are not just, they fix it, you. The Lord is not into just fixing. He wants you to be a new creation, okay? And then it tells also quicken means greater powers of life. Powers! So there's so much we need to know more in the spiritual life. Do we think we know already? I want to go walk in the supernatural. I want to see supernatural. That when I walk, then people get healed. When I see, when things are not happening I'm good, I can see what the other members are doing. And I can teleport and say, we pray for you. So, like, I want you to dream. Don't be satisfied on your situation right now. That's not a low living. God doesn't want you in low living. He wants you to elevate your present living. Greater power of life to give increase of life. Not into God is not into decrease living. He doesn't want you to just, come on, Rhoda, let me decrease your life. No, you need to increase living, okay? And then he said here, what kind of life? Zoe, which is the God kind of life. Zoe means the God kind of life. The life of this divine. The life which is divine. Walking in a divine life. And it starts when you're born again Christian. What is that born again? When you said, God, I'm open. You don't know what you receive. You said that, Lord, I receive you as my Lord and Savior. You know that the Holy Spirit came inside of you and resides on you, and you have possibility to do wonders. Amen. You are not ordinary person. Amen. Are you ordinary person? No. You are peculiar people, the Bible says. Amen. A peculiar people. A person is supernatural. Born again life. Anybody? Let me ask you again. Who among you said, I'm a born again Christian and I know? Romans 8:11 said, the same I already discussed that. And then here, the Holy Spirit raised Jesus from the dead. It's the Holy Spirit who raised Jesus from the dead. It's the same Holy Spirit lives inside of you. He's your best friend. He is your power when you're down. Now, why cannot we see the good things. Why I'm seeing all bad stuff happening? Because of our belief. If you know, can I go back to the verse on the... Okay, let me just go there. Because it's so important. When Jesus, so they are having dinner, okay? They're having dinner, the 11 of them. And then, still later, he appeared to the 11 disciples as they were eating together. He rebuked them for their stubborn unbelief. What's the problem of Christianity now, walking into natural life, is stubborn unbelief. It's not only unbelief, stubborn. That's why you cannot see miracles, because you're stubborn unbelief. I didn't say that. The word says that. That's why before you can see miracles, before supernatural, like you want, if you're a businessman here, if you want to see miracles, remove unbelief. Stubborn unbelief. You need to rebuke that. If you want to be successful in life, remove unbelief. And it says stubborn. He rebuked it. You need to remove it. He rebuked it, the unbelief, because he refused to believe those who have been him after him, he had been raised from the dead. Then this I like about. After that, then he told them, go into all the world and preach the good news. After rebuking the stubborn unbelief, he commissioned you to do something. After eradicating the unbelief, your commission to do miracles in your hands and to your mouth. And then he said, if anyone who believes and is baptized and be saved, but anyone who refuses to believe will be condemned. This miracle signs will accompany those who believe. Apart from believing, you will not have miracles. Apart from believing, no answered prayer. If you keep on praying, but with unbelief, stop praying. It won't do good. Now what you need to do is to work on your believing part. And how you do the work on the believing part? Easy. Meditate on the Word of God. Love the Word of God. Change your mindset. Let your every neuron of your brain be persuaded. Be captivated by the Word of God. And when you're captivated by the Word of God, you agree on the miracles. Hallelujah. They will cast out demons. I hear more. He said here, these miracles will sign and accompany those who believe. They will cast out demons. Do you know that you don't play with demons? Don't entertain demons. You rebuke them. And my name, and they will speak in new language, speaking tongues, and then you're able to handle snakes. Okay, don't handle snakes, okay? Oh, the Bible says I can handle snake, get a rattlesnake. You! If your faith can do that, go for it. Make sure your faith is really high, okay? Let me get the snake. Ah, rattlesnake. Ah, come on, baby, baby. No. All right? And then, but the thing is like, you pray for the sick, you know, what will happen? All of us will pray for the sick. Even though you feel like they're not getting healed, just pray for them. You don't, it's God who heals, not you, okay? Okay, just don't try to make the gymnastic and all try to heal and tongues and pray. Lay your hands to the sick and that's it. He take care of that rest. You're not God, amen? Okay, and then, things a lot have happened, but I'm going to close. Almost, I'm about to finish. And the light, God is calling us to a higher level of believing. I want to know Christ. So how can we have that believing part, Pastor Bob? How can we have that believing part? And this is it. I want to know Christ. Know is meditation. You need to know Christ. You need to love Christ. You need to know more about him. It's like, we know in the Philippines, we have this halo-halo. What's halo-halo? It's like a... dessert stuff wherein it's cold, icy stuff, but at the bottom, you have the stuff, the goody-goody stuff. So what you do is like when you eat, you mix it, and the more you go down on the bottom, there's so much yummy stuff. So that, I don't know why did I say that, but anyway. It's a connection. But anyway, the more you meditate the Word of God, the more you taste it, it's like you go deeper. Deep, yummy. It's just, it's how you to know Christ, by His Word, by loving His Word. I want to know Christ. Yes, to know the power of His resurrection. Two things that He wants you to do, to know Christ and to know the power of resurrection. And also participate in His suffering, becoming like Him in His death. Do you think that Christianity is all bed of roses? No, there's persecution. There's struggle. But the good thing of it is there is God. There is a God that can take care of you. In Philippians 3, another translation said, I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised Him from the dead. Come on, anybody here really want this verse? I want to know Christ and really experience the power of resurrection. I want to know the power of His resurrection. From the dead, I want to suffer with Him, sharing from His dead. It's the power of resurrection. The Bible says, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, shall live. He will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this? Let's all stand up on our feet. I want you to bow your head. I want you to just think about what we talk about.